is always
thanks for
watching. Today the topic is introduction to microbiology.
Before I start the explanation, I want to say that there are a keywords signed in red to help in understanding the main ideas in every slide. I will explain the general ideas in the slide and ask you to pay attention carefully to the written sentences to facilitate the understanding process smoothly in every slide. Let's begin. In this slide, I will explain the definition of the word microbiology. Micro meaning small, bio meaning life, and logy meaning study of. From these three words, more than one definition of the word microbiology was derived, and I have written some definitions. The first, microbiology means the study of organisms that are too small to be seen without magnification. Pay attention, guys, to the sentence, especially the word without and not with, because it is not seen with the naked eye and needs a microscope. Second definition, microbiology is a study of microbes that infect humans, host cells. The last one, microbiology is the study of microscopic and not macroscopic organisms such as bacteria, fungi, protozoa, algae, and of course viruses. In some of the questions, they ask to choose a simple definition of the word microbiology. Therefore, attention must be paid to what I explain. This slide describes the branches of microbiology that we will study in depth together, and they are as follows: bacteriology, immunology, mycology, nematology, parasitology, and virology. In this slide, I will talk about the history of microbiology. And I have mentioned the three most important scientists who were the founders of microbiology, and they are Antonin van Leeuwenhoek, Louis Pasteur, and Robert Koch. Antonin was called the father of microbiology, and he was the first person who noticed the types of bacteria, which were later known as small animalcules, depending on the difference in shape, size, and motility. Also, he discovered grinding lenses to study accurately the causative agent of various diseases. Louis Pasteur. He became obsessed with learning about living things when he studied the fermentation process. In this process, materials are broken down into smaller materials without the presence of oxygen. They use microorganisms for industrial needs like wine, beer, and bread. This process is achieved by yeast or bacteria. And another example is lactobacillus. This bacteria is used in the manufacture of yogurt. He discovered sterilization techniques to get rid of unpleasant microbes. An example of these tools that are used today are autoclave, radiation, filtration, chemical methods, and gases. He discovered the basics of effective vaccination. In fact, this effective vaccination is used to stimulate immune cells in the body after exposure to a foreign body. Immune cells produce antibodies immediately that recognize the foreign body and store information about this body in order to recognize it when infected and get rid of it immediately. He invented vaccinations against Vibrio cholera, which caused cholera, Bacillus anthrax, which caused anthrax, and Lyssa virus, which caused rabies. Robert Koch. The two most important points are, the first is a German bacteriologist. Second, he determined pathogens to combat the transmission of infection between people, which at that time were considered fatal, such as Mycobacterium tuberculosis, which cause tuberculosis, Vibrio cholera, which cause cholera, and Bacillus anthrax, which cause anthrax. This slide shows the difference between light microscope and electron microscope. I have written some nuances, and I want to say only important information, which is that in an electron microscope, we see only viruses and bacteria that contain flagella. Viruses are considered part of the micrometer, but their size is expressed in nanometer. Here are some nuances that I have written for you. In this slide, I illustrate the parts of a compound microscope. Above there, where is the mouse, move, there is the ocular lens, and it is always considered constant. The magnification force of the lens is equivalent to 10, while at the bottom, there are objective lenses, which has a different magnification power. From here, we got an equation, which is A multiplied B equals total magnification. I hope that you have benefited from the information, and whoever has any comments, please write it at the bottom of the video on the first topic of microbiology, and I will answer all the questions. Thanks you for following up. I will see you next week with a new topic. Have a good day.